Well, guys, welcome to Friday, day three of our new way of doing school. I know that originally I posted a thing on GroupMe suggesting that we have a meeting, but then remembered that we said we weren't going to meet on Friday, and I didn't want anybody to miss this, so I figured that I would do it as a video, and that makes it less time sensitive, and Ella will not have to take notes for us all. So what I wanted to do, using our calendar as our place of focus, is I wanted to talk you through the way that we will be moving forward for the next few days. So if you look over here with me on the 20th, and I know that this doesn't look great, I'm trying to draw with a mouse. A lot of this should look familiar. I actually decided to switch things back. I know I said originally we were going to do slightly soluble salts and then weak titrations. That was originally just because I was trying to put the shorter salt stuff on what would have been, Monday the 16th, but none of that matters anymore. So we're going to do these in order. So on the 20th, we'll look at weak titrations. You'll notice that everything's the same. We've got slides, we've got solutions, we've got screencast. But then in addition to that, you'll notice that it also says homework reporting. And that is the homework reporting link for this assignment. So if we click on that, just to give you a sense of what that looks like, guys, this is the way we're going to turn in our homework. Just first name, last name, and then you know the drill. Is your homework done? Did you get your questions answered? It's just a yes or no, just like always. And so you'll notice that that system carries on throughout the coming days. You'll notice, though, however, if you look over here on the 23rd, I know a B day is not our class, but just to lend consistency, I thought I would put our review hours on Mondays, regardless of if that is an A day or a B day. Certainly, you can record these things early. All of this stuff is there now. So if you just want to front load this and rush through it, that's fine. Please don't do that with review hours. Don't get ahead on review hours. Let's do these in sync. That's the idea of spreading this stuff out for us. But you'll notice here there's also a link, same thing, just a Google form, first name, last name, and did you do your hours? So thinking about this idea of review hours, I frankly don't know exactly where you all are in terms of your hours. But what I was thinking was let's record week 2 hours, which I think most of you are done with. Let's record our week 2 hours on the 23rd and then just move forward from there. We've agreed on 2 hours of review per week. Again, keeping with the week being then the big idea that we're studying. And guys, you may find that 2 hours is not enough. Certainly, you're welcome to do more. If you'd like to talk about this, communicate either through GroupMe or through email. I really don't have a sense of what your guys' challenges and time constraints are. If you'd like to re-examine that, I'm certainly open to it. The other thing that I'd like to point out is that starting on the 24th, you'll notice, well, all along, but here on the 24th, we've got a link to a Google meeting. And what I'd like to do is I'd like to continue to be available at 10:30 on our normal class days. My thought being that, like, for example, on the 24th, we could do our Google meeting at 10:30 and answer questions about the homework that you got on the 20th. Looking over the weak titration stuff. Then on the 24th, you'll have the KSP stuff. Again, the homework recording is there. And then let's talk next week about what the test is going to look like. You'll notice that that's on the 26th. I don't know yet what that's going to entail, but let's be in touch. So then after the 26th, Moving down to the 20, or I'm sorry, to the 30th, guys, you'll notice the 30th gets a little bit complicated. So now we're in the next unit, chapter 20. So we will have a chapter 20 summary that's due then. Still available for a Google Meet if we need to talk about anything. Notice that you're also recording your week 3 hours. And then we have the first of the stuff from Electrochem. I know that seems like a lot, but remember on the 26th, you took a test. The redox stuff, is something to watch and do in the future. Hopefully, that chapter 20 summary doesn't take you long. You should already have your week 3 hours done. So I if that's too much or overwhelming, please let me know. I'd love to talk. Then, guys, moving forward into the month of April. There we go. Looking forward into the month of April. On the first, we have voltaic cells. Please notice that there is a handout on this day. I would encourage you to print this. It's actually a schematic of a battery that will be helpful for you as you go over the material for that day. And then everything should be standardized there. Then, guys, on Friday the 3rd, we have our last day of new material in AP. Unbelievable. It's all about the spontaneity of electrochemical reactions. Again, the link should be familiar given what we've talked about earlier in this video. Then, guys, notice after that we're spring break. There are places here on our Mondays to record our review hours. I know that originally our review schedule had us getting done with review hours over the week of spring break. That's extended simply because of the way, well, the craziness of our days. And so, guys, if you're ahead of the game relative to your review hours, feel free to record what you've got. And then we can, obviously you can be doing other things. I'm frankly not yet sure how we're going to handle review after spring break. We are going to take a break during spring break. And then coming back after spring break, we'll hopefully know more about the status of the test. Hopefully, we'll just have a clearer sense of what these days are going to look like. And then after spring break, we can pick up from there and talk about what we want to do with review. Now, as this all applies to your grades, again, I don't want this to be a stressor, but I know that structure is important too. So homeworks are homeworks. Your review hours and that chapter 20 summary will count as projects. And then obviously we'll have two tests. And again, not clear on exactly what that means, but that's what we'll be doing with that. So, guys, I hope that this proves to be an effective way to share information with you. I still really want to do these Google meetings, frankly, if for no other reason than just because it was good to hear your voices. But it also provides, bi-directional communication and not just me talking at a computer screen. I think that was the best way to handle this, but going forward, let's continue to do our Google Meets. Guys, again, love your feedback if you have ideas on what we can be doing better. And if there's anything I can do to support you, whether it's in this class or other classes, if you need a liaison with other teachers, know that I'm here for you. So I will jump off of here and throw a thing up on GroupMe, letting everybody know about this video. And so really that just means that moving forward for Friday, just watch the screencast, do the homework, and we can gather again. After the weekend. So have a great weekend. Hope you guys are well. Make sure you're getting outdoors, get some sun, laugh a lot, watch VeggieTales, whatever it takes. Miss you guys, and we'll talk to you soon. Bye.